You are welcome to the broadcast of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International. In this broadcast, join International Crusade and Conference Speaker, Teacher, Senior Pastor, Apostle, General Overseer and Presiding Prelate of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International, Bishop Akintayo Samjoli.
I announce to you, whatever was to follow you, that is not from God, it will not follow you, it will not follow your children.
His teachings and ministries have brought deliverance and transformation to many lives and families across the nation and beyond. Receive God's word with faith in your heart and watch your life move from glory to glory.
Now, for a few minutes, we want to remind ourselves about what we began to look at as we discussed the error of forgetting God, the error of forgetting God. And I trust that you'd allow this word to sink into your heart and do not make the error of forgetting God. So we established yesterday that it is the nature of man to forget, but that nature came from Satan. It was not there by God. It was not put in the heart of men by God. It was put into man's heart. On the contrary, it is God's nature to remember and not to forget us. It is God's nature to remember all what we do for him. And in Hebrews 6 verse 10, it says, "For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which you have showed toward his name, in that you have ministered to the saints and do minister." So God does not forget what we've done and what we continue to do for him. And that's a great plus for us. And we also see in Ecclesiastes 12, verse 1, the word of God says, "Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them." And so we looked at some reasons why people forget God and why people forget God. And one of it we see here in this verse, it says that the evil days come not, that is, they have not yet come. And the years when people lack, have no pleasure in them, have not yet come. And so when people are doing well, when people are flourishing, they tend to forget God. Human nature is to forget God when everything is well, when everything is flowing nicely. Now, what does it mean to forget God? We looked at a few things. We said it means to turn away from the truth. When you forget God, you turn away from the truth of his word. Number two, it means to go back to the former life without Christ, without Jesus Christ. You used to live in a certain way, and God brought you out, God saved you. God revealed his love to you, but now you've turned away from that. You've gone back to your former way of living. You were once an alcoholic, and God saved you. You moved away from it, but then you've gone back to it. You were living in immorality, and God saved you. But now you've gone back to your former way of living. So number three, it means to stop following the life of Christ. You no longer walk in holiness, no longer walk in purity, no longer walk in generosity, in forgiveness, in kindness. You no longer walk in the life of God. Number four, it means to end the place of fellowship you'd reached in God. So you used to walk with God in a certain way, but now you've ended that fellowship with God. And so we're talking about what it means to forget God, right? So you can be able to see by these and many other points, if you have forgotten God or not, all right? Number five, it means to stop having quality time with God personally. to stop having quality time with God personally. You used to have time with God. You know, so forgetting God does not mean that you just forget that God exists. No, they are indicators. And the fifth one is that you stop having quality time with God personally. And so you find that if it's not in church or if it's not a corporate call, you cannot talk with God. You do not read your Bible on your own. You do not pray on your own. And that is an act that shows that you've forgotten God. And number six, to stop having fellowship with God's family. You no longer go to church. You're no longer in his presence. You no longer join covenant families. You no longer join family devotion. That is what it means to forget God. It also means to stop giving your tithes, your offerings, financial support to God's work. It is an indication that you have forgotten God. You've forgotten God. Number eight, to stop laboring in God's house. These are the things that happen when people forget God. What you used to do, you do it no more. How you used to serve, you serve no more. Right? So, I want you to assess this morning if you have forgotten God or not.
Assess this morning if you've forgotten God
or not. Hallelujah. Now, when people forget God, it is because, like we said, one, the evil day has not yet come. And that is why they forget God. Hallelujah. When troubles have not yet come, or when people are doing well, they forget God. Hallelujah. I pray that in the midst of your prosperity, you would remember God. In the midst of your prosperity, you'd stay faithful to God. Hallelujah. In the midst of your prosperity, I pray that you would not turn your back on God.
Hallelujah. It is an error to turn your back on Almighty God. It is an error for you to forget God. Glory be to God. Now, also, people forget God when they are faced with difficult situations. When you are faced with difficulties, some forget God, and then they turn elsewhere for help when people forget God. Further, people forget God when they now have options. Someone can now do something for them. You know, it's just like when people have now said that, okay, you know, I'll help you with this. And the same person who used to go after God now knows that somebody that could give me this, somebody could provide this for me. It's like some people who start serving God, and then at a certain point, you know, they now are more affluent. They now have more resources available. They now switch and say, okay, I am doing politics now. God has led me to politics, which was not so before. Now, when they came to God having nothing, and now they're blessed, and now begin leading them to and saying to them, but you realize that it is basically an act of showing an evidence that you've forgotten God. Also, people forget God when they're better connected with helpers. They now have people to help them, to support them, and they tend to forget God. And number five, when people have positions and answers that they desired, they were looking for something that has been given to them. They have the position they wanted. They have the answers they desire. Okay, they're now promoted. In fact, you can separate that into number six, because now they have answers, right? They were searching for this and they now have this. So what is all this whole thing about going to God? They now have the answers they need. Today, I want you to know and to remember. Let's go back to what we saw yesterday and remind us that there are consequences to those that forget God. In Job 8, verse 13, they sow at the paths of all that forget God, and the hypocrite's hope shall perish. The devil is only drifting you as far as can get you to go from God, and then he will smite. When he succeeded to pull you away from God, then he will smite. The Bible says the hypocrite's hope shall perish. I want to see clearly from this verse that God compares those who forget them, equates them to being hypocrites. When you forget God, you are a hypocrite. Psalm 9, verse 17. And the consequence, what is the most serious and most severe consequence? Psalm 9, verse 17. The wicked shall be torn into hell, and all the nations that forget God. So the Bible calls those who forget God wicked. It is a wicked person who forgets God. Now, someone has to go up to you to attend church. Someone has to encourage you to be a part. Someone has to beg you and overcome your excuses, your accusations, your offenses. You're not going to church because they did this to me. That was done to me. But the issue is that you've forgotten God, and the Bible says the end of it is that you shall be turned into hell, given over to hell, handed over to hell, and all nations that forget God. Today, I call on us to go back and see, have we forgotten God? Look at the signs of those who forget God. Look at what happens. Those who forget God, and ask yourself, am I walking with God, or have I forgotten God? What place does God occupy in my life? Am I giving him the time that I used to give? We'll look at evidences later on in another broadcast. Look some more at what would help us to know. Look at indicators that will help you to know that I have made a mistake. I have turned against God. But according to Deuteronomy 8, verse 11 to 12 to 20, remember that when people forget God, you don't hear testimonies in their mouth. They attribute the praises to themselves. I have done this. I have done that. The rich man said, I worked hard. My field has produced great results for me. Now I'm going to say to my soul, you become the governor of your soul, the ruler of your own life. No one tells you what to do. You're not on the instructions anymore. You're now your own commander, your own pastor, your own God. I will do this. I will do that. There's nothing being done towards God. It's not like I'm going to help. I'm going to give this towards God. Oh, God, thank you for providing for me. No, it's I have done this. I've done well. I studied well. I passed my exams. I spent nights in studies. I had great insight into investment. My business is now thriving. I have good connections. Testimonies away from the mouth. You now attribute everything to yourself and to others. Thank God for that friend who helped me. That's one of the challenges of being a pastor. When you pray and God provides help for people, people remember those who were used as a channel. They do not remember those who prayed for the channel to appear. And that is an error. I challenge you today. Now, here we are. Seeking God, turn your heart towards God, turn your faith towards God, seek him and ask him to intervene and to help you. Seek him and ask him to prevail on your behalf. Seek God. Do not depend on your mere strength. The devil will get you away from God and then smite you. Do not depend. Do not forget God. Do not forget what he has done for you.
I believe you've been tremendously blessed by this program with such powerful exposition of God's Word. Join the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International in our next broadcast. Also join us in worship at the Faith Cathedral 5 and 7 Victoria Street in Freetown on Sundays at 7 and 9 a.m. and Thursdays at 6 p.m. For prayers, counseling, and testimony, please call +232 309 0007 or +232 77 853 207 or +232 77 858 1 51. This is the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International.